thank you and we bless you this great morning. As we sit under your feet, that you may feed us on your word, we pray that, Lord, you will. As we open up our hearts, we pray that you will feed us. And Father, we thank you that you have called us from each and every various places just to come and be edified by your word. Bless us and be with us as we go through this sermon. For this we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Kindly have your seats. Hosea chapter 10, verse 12. Sow for yourselves righteousness. Reap steadfast love. Break up your fallow ground. For it is time to seek the Lord, that he may come and rain righteousness upon you. Last week we went into length talking about this theme. Break up your fallow ground. I want to briefly speak about a plan for repentance that this same text brings to us. It is talks because Hosea is prophesying at a very difficult moment for the children of Israel and especially the northern kingdom. He's prophesying at a very, very dangerous time when they have already forsaken God. It is a time that Hosea is pleading with the children of Israel to go back to God. He's calling them to return back to God. When somebody calls you to return back to God, it means that you have already left that journey, isn't you? And that is why Hosea is reminding them, where you are, you have already left that direction. And he's calling them back to God, so that they may come back to God and worship God. Hosea is prophesying as a time when the children of Israel had replaced the temple of God with the worship of Betaven. Betaven is an evil spirit that they were worshiping. They had replaced the temple of God with the temple of evil. They were in the time they had already forsaken the God of Israel. Now they were worshiping evil in the temple of God. Even in today's our time, we see people who call themselves pastors, but they involve witchcraft in the ministry. They involve themselves in witchcraft to succeed in their ministry, not forgetting that this ministry is not ours, but this ministry is God's. Praise God. Therefore, Hosea is speaking at a very dangerous time for the children of God and is calling them back to repentance. It is a time that they had already replaced the temple of God. They had already given great money, a lot of money, to Assyria to protect them. And that's why Assyria later on came and captured them and took everything they had. They had already protected that somebody will not Assyria. They had given, already invested into this God, into this guy, the demon I'm calling, Betaven, to protect them from Assyria coming to capture them. And this is the time they had already decided to become slaves to the idols. Friends, any time in your life you think that you can replace God with an alternative, it will work against you. These people he decided to replace God with an alternative, just exactly as the same Israelites did in the wilderness. They decided to replace God with idols. They decided to replace God so that they may worship a statue which they can see, rather than worshiping God of Moses, whom they were not seeing, but they were told to believe. We are living in the same time in our life that we need to worship our God whom we believe, not to replace God with things that we can see with our eyes. Challenges have come in many people's lives, and you know, if you want to test a Christian, bring in challenges into the lives of a Christian. You know, one person one day told me she was fired from where she was working. Her children, one of them died. Some were already ill. One became crippled. And this lady was a committed leader in the church. She told me she decided to start hopping from one church to another church, seeking remedies for the family issues. I laughed at her and told her, no remedy you will find as you hop church to church. Remedy rests with you, praise God. And the remedy for our challenges no one has them. All these remedies are with us. And the remedy for our solution or for our problems is our faith, praise God. It is our faith that once we believe that our God is able, no matter what challenges come, so long as we put our faith in this God, we shall succeed regardless of the challenges. So the remedy for us is not to hop from place to place, but it is to choose to soak ourselves in the presence of God. Once God is in us, nothing will hinder our progress. And that's why Hosea says, sow to yourself righteousness. He's not saying that sow to God righteousness. He's saying sow to yourself righteousness. Because whatever you do, it works against. You know, when you are arrested by police, they say, keep quiet, or whatever you say, it will be? It will be? Yes. Whatever you say, it is against you. So whatever you sow, it is not for any other one. It is for yourself. When you sow faith in your life and in your walk with Christ, that faith, it will be worked against you. Whatever you do, it will be worked against you. When you choose to involve into other idol worship, they still will work out of you. I know people. Many years ago, I heard of a guy who joined a devil worshiping cult. And as usual, I don't know if it was true or it was a story. This guy joined into that cult, and every Friday they would go to worship this cult. And then for the cult to get well, you were to kill, to sacrifice one of your kid or your parents. So the first one, the dad was drunkard and was bothersome in the family. So he decided to sacrifice his father. And for sure, wealth came. And he started now getting millions of money, changing vehicles, marrying several women, money's coming. And as money came in, and the devil told him, you need to sacrifice another one, or else the wealth will go, and you will die. And then he said, either you sacrifice your mother now. He said, my mother, no. He looked at his one of the children who was rude one, he sacrificed that one. came back again and he harvested well. But every time the money comes, again the rule of the game comes back. Again, now you need to sacrifice another one. Or else all the wealth will disappear and you will be sacrificed. He sacrificed until now, all the children were dead. He remained with the mother. And then the rule was that you need to sacrifice your mother. It's when he said, I better die, but not sacrifice my mother. And as he said, wealth disappeared, he died, and his mother died. Because the game was, as you are in this world, this game, you must sacrifice all your family. So whatever you do, it works against you. When you so righteous to God, that righteous will work against, will work for you, will work for you to progress in the ways, in the world of faith, whatever you do. And that when time comes for the farmer, and right now, where I come from, farmers are plowing. Some have begun planting. No one would go and plant in a ground like this one. Because when water comes, no water will come. Get inside. Water will just roll away. So all of them, as they prepare to plant, they have to plow. And you can only plant in a very soft soil. Isn't that correct?
Yes.
No one will plant in a very hardy place because the seeds will not germinate. It's the same thing to our faith. For us to succeed, we must plow our heart. Our heart must be ready to allow the Spirit of God to settle in. Unless the Spirit of God can settle in our hearts, whatever we do will not succeed. So it works for us if we work on our heart, if we repent and we turn to God, all this will work for us. We must cultivate the soil. We have to break up the fallow ground for us to succeed. In Ecclesiastes 11, verse 4, it says, whoever observes the wind will not sow, and whoever regards the clouds will not reap. You know, you get a farmer, when other people are already plowing their ground, preparing for the planting, and he's saying, you people, you are struggling with this heavy ground, and yet there's no rain. Because the wind is blowing and there's no rain, nothing is forthcoming, now you feel you are laughing at them. Whoever observes the wind will not sow. Because you are observing the wind is blowing, you want to see how the wind is blowing for you to start plowing, you will not sow. And whoever regards the clouds will not reap. You see now the climate has changed. The traditional farmers will have problem. And I'm pitying my mother who is a traditional farmer. I don't know if we'll have harvest right now. Because in traditional right now, rain should be now preparing to begin. See you? But now already it is raining very heavily. So the farmer must plug in right now and begin planting, or else they will not harvest. And that is why the Ecclesiastes is saying, you will not harvest if you do that, if you don't obey that. If you continue to regarding the wind, you will not plant. And if you disobey the clouds, you will not reap. And Proverbs 20 verse 4 says, the lazy person does not plow in season. The lazy person does not plow in season. Harvest comes and there is nothing to be found. The next person, right now, other people are already sleeping because you know right now other farmers are in the garden doing what? Plowing, isn't it? But somebody say, mufuwa na hii matope, mimi siyeni. Mimi nitaenda kama kumekauka kidogo. Because they are lazy. By the time they will be waking up to go to the garden, the other seeds will be already germinated, they will be weeding. But these other ones will be still struggling to plow. So, the same to us as Christians. Those who say, I will not give my life to Jesus now. I want to wait. I will give my life to Jesus next year. I'll give my life to Jesus the other year. You are regarding the clouds. By the time you want to give your life to Jesus, it will be too late. Praise God. So let us not wait for another time. The time is today that we must plow our hearts. We must seek God. We must repent so that God may have precedence in our lives. God must take position in our hearts when it is time for Him to settle in our hearts. The spiritual life of many people is like the hard and plowed ground. There is lack of Bible reading for many of us. When we talk of fellowship, meter fellowship, we do not come. Even at in your house, you do not have family Bible study. You do not have time to pray. You do not have time to worship. When you are regarding all these things, you are exactly what Hosea is talking about. Because when your heart is empty, something else will come in. The same spirits will come in. And the same challenges will come your way. Therefore, let us break up our fallow ground so that God may find a place in our hearts. Nothing can succeed unless we choose God. We have been praying in this church, but people have not loosened their hearts for God to get in and have opportunity to transform them. Transformation does not come from our mind. Transformation comes from our hearts. So we need God to find a space in our hearts. But God will not find a space in our hearts when our hearts are hardened, when our hearts has no place. Whenever your heart is full of things, God will not come in. You must empty that heart for God to find a space in your hearts. Praise God.
Amen.
Therefore, as I finish, you have plowed wickedness. You have reaped injustice. You have eaten the fruit of lies because you have trusted in your power and in the multitude of your warriors. Hosea is reminding the children of Israel that they have plowed wickedness. When people are plowing righteousness, others are plowing wickedness. You have reaped injustices. Many people have done injustices of doing evil to others. Many people are good in maligning others, where you sit and you draft a story and you malign other person, and you can paint that story to be true. I can go to Karoga and say, I have seen your wife kissing another man, and I can paint that story that at the time Karoga gets in his house, he's already fired and he has it as gospel truth. Friends, we need to be careful. Whatever we plow, when we plow wicked, we shall harvest wicked. As we plant injustices, we will harvest injustices. And because of that, many of us have eaten the fruits of lies. Because we are the kings of lies. We are the kings, people who say what is not godly. We are in good in that. We must stop and seek God so that God may found a space in our hearts. Without that, friends, it will not be as usual in our lives. Because you have trusted in your power and in the multitude of your warriors, he's telling them that they have trusted in their powers and they have trusted in their warriors. They have forsaken God. They are no longer trusting in God. They are no longer trusting in the power of God. They are trusting in their warriors because their hearts are hardened. And therefore, Hosea is calling them to repentance. And therefore, this morning, I call you, beloved, that let us open our hearts and repent so that God may find a space in our hearts, so that God may turn what has been eaten by the enemy, that God may return it back. Father, we thank you and bless you for your word. We pray that, Lord, we have plowed so many vices in our lives. We have plowed things which are not glorifying you. We repent, God, that, Father, you may forgive us and you may find a space in our hearts as we open our hearts for you, that, Lord, we may worship you, we may live for you, we may seek you in season and out of season. Father, we pray that may we turn to you and sow righteousness which will be for our gain. Lord, we worship you and we honor you. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.